Hello there, bookworms! Welcome back to my channel. My name is Annie, and today's video is the first in a new series of short videos I came up with, where I will be recommending lesser-known and really underappreciated books that I've really seen nobody talking about before. And the book I chose for the opening video is an adult science fiction novel that only came out last year, and it is Seven Devils by Elizabeth May and Laura Lem. So in case you couldn't tell from the cover, this is a feminist and queer space opera, so I knew I was gonna love this book before I even started it. I got this for Christmas in 2020, and I read it back in January, and I ended up rating it 4.5 stars. I will leave a link to my full spoiler-free Goodreads review in my description, so you can head over there and check that out if you want to. I now want to tell you a bit about what this book is about, and in the end I'm gonna read you two short quotes that I marked that I absolutely loved. Throughout the book there are a bunch of important characters, and many of them have their own point of views. But there are two main characters, and the first one is Eris. She was born to be the heir to the galaxy's most ruthless empire, but she didn't want to be that person anymore, so she faked her death many years ago and joined the resistance against the Tholosian Empire under her new name of Eris. That is not her real name. And while working for the resistance, one day Eris gets a new assignment. She is assigned to infiltrate another spaceship to gather intelligence that might be of use for the resistance, because this spaceship is believed to be carrying deadly cargo. But the person that Eris is supposed to go on this mission with, and the second main character of the book, is no one else than Chloelia, or Chlo for short. She is a mechanic and a pilot working for the resistance, and she holds an oath grudge against Eris. So the two of them really shouldn't be working together on their own. But then they find the ship, and they have to put their differences aside, because on the ship they find some refugees from the Tholosian Empire, and these women have information that might help the resistance. But they all have to work together, and they have to do it fast, because the new heir to the Empire plans to disrupt the peace summit with the only remaining alien civilization, because he wants to push forward with the expansion of the Empire. And let me just read out the last sentence of the synopsis to you, because I really couldn't have said it better on my own. If they can find a way to stop him, they will save the galaxy. If they can't, millions may die. So this book truly had everything I'm looking for in a good space adventure. It was fast-paced, there was lots of action, and the characters were all so well fleshed out and interesting. They had their own personalities, and that made it very interesting to see them all try and work together, which, as you may have guessed already, doesn't always go that well. All in all, this book is more on the action side of things, but it also has some heavily implied romances. I only recommend it to every science fiction fan, especially if you like strong and kick-ass feel characters, and if you're looking for LGBTQ and especially lesbian representation in your science fiction book, because this has it all. And now, to end this video with, I'm gonna read you two short quotes that I marked and that I absolutely loved. Rhea's life in the pleasure garden, as vast as the garden was, had been a cage. The walls there were so high, so impossible to climb. Rhea would often stare up at the stars and wonder what it was like to travel, what it was like beyond those vast walls. There were whole worlds, people like Chlo, people from different lands, and she wanted to learn about it all. And quote number two, and the one I will be ending this video with, is a longer one. Chlo turned on the hyperdrive, Zelos quivered. Time itself seemed to pause, and then the pinpoints of stars shifted from white to blue, then violet, then disappeared to ultraviolet. The hazy blue of cosmic rays came into view, then sharpened to white in the center. Chlo let out her breath. She loved this feeling. Jumping light years, bending time and space. It felt like magic, like she took the power of the seven gods for herself. The ship slowed, stilled. Before them was the quiet of space. Chlo let her heart rate calm before she started the whole process up again. Up there, without true gravity and atmosphere, she felt no star sickness. There was only the joy of slipping through the void, of doing something the humans were not meant to do, to conquer the stars. They jumped again, and Chlo closed her eyes. She took her hands off the controls, just for a moment, to open her arms wide. So this was the first video in my series of book recommendations. I hope you liked it. If you did, then give it a thumbs up, and maybe consider subscribing to my channel or to my book blog. Tell me down below in the comments if you like this video and if the book sounds interesting to you, because I would love to hear your opinions about everything. I hope to see you again in my next video, and until then, happy reading! Bye bye!